start. In a brief talk before leaving the jail, Hamid Raza had told the media that there had been progress in the party and had hoped that the fourth round to be held at Governor House would be conclusive. He had claimed that the TLP chief had appealed to his party activists to remain peaceful. The government is currently engaging with the workers of the TLP who have been holding anti-France protests for more than a week after a clash with the police in Lahore on Sunday. The TLP has put forth four demands: the expulsion of the French ambassador over president, explicit backing of sketches of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, the release of party chief Saad Rizvi, the removal of the ban on the party, and the release of activists arrested, as well as the FIRs against them to be revoked. On Sunday, the city of Lahore became a battleground as workers of the recently banned party and policemen clashed. TLP workers also took 11 policemen hostage, who were later released after the first round of talks with the government. On Monday, Prime Minister Imran Khan said that although his government and the TLP had the same goal to end incidents of this kind around the world, their methodologies to deal with the issue were different. In a televised address to the nation, the Premier referred to the violence by a TLP activist over the last week after their leader's arrest and the government crackdown as regrettable incidents. Imran said, like the TLP, the government too wanted that there was no this kind of attacks against the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, in any country. Only our methods are different, he said, noting that while the TLP wanted the France ambassador to be expelled and Pakistan relations to be better with France, his government had adopted a different strategy. He continued, around Salman Rushdie wrote a book in which he disrespected our prophet. The public came out on Pakistani streets. The American embassy was attacked and people were martyred too.